Coming. Hi, girl.
What's going on?
Girl, you look good.
Not enough.
Girl, where are you up to?
Like I'll tell you.
Don't you just know.
Weekend. So what do I offer you?
Nothing.
Don't tell me you're still watching your weight.
Will I ever stop?
You want to be like me?
Yes, is it you?
Girl, I told you travel to Port Harcourt.
For where? No, yesterday was Clara's wedding. And you weren't there.
Helen, you don't expect me to attend such a low-class wedding, do you?
Victoria, it was a normal wedding. They really tried.
They tried. There are certain weddings I attend. They must be classy, elegant, full of dignitaries. Those are the kind of weddings I attend, right? And I'm not going to spare any expenses on my own wedding, trust me.
And when would that be, Princess?
Very soon. I am taking my time.
Taking your time with, what's his name again?
Who?
Steve.
Eh? Steve? Who is that? Is that a name? From which family? Just because he bought himself a Jeep and a Jaguar, does that make him the right man for me? Please, girl, say something else now.
Okay. Just out of curiosity, humor me. Who is the right guy?
Good question. The guy must be rich, made, well-connected, dine and wine with kings, and must be a young bachelor. That is the right man.
What a tall order. In that case, you're waiting for the president's son, if he still has any that is not married, or the vice president's son to propose to you. Girl, you say this all the time, you know, and I just take it as, you know, as a practical joke, with a pinch of salt, because I know you're not really serious.
Girl, I am dead serious, okay? That is the kind of man I want to get married to. Yeah. For crying out loud, this is my life, my future, and I am in full control of it.
There are many eligible bachelors parading themselves in front of you for marriage. Girl, all you have to do is pick. I mean, you are beautiful, working class, and here's the word I'm searching for.
Wife material in the making, you know? Girl, don't waste it.
Oh, God, Helen, exactly. And I will not waste all this on a 100,000 naira per salary struggling bachelor. I won't do that, okay? Girl, do you know how much I spend on just the perfume alone? Do you know how much it takes me to look so tushed like this? And you want me to waste it on a one car and a flat struggling man? Girl, please.
Okay, back off. I know when to do that.
Yeah, you should do that.
It's your life. I mean, who am I to advise?
Don't advise me.
It looks like you're home alone.
Yeah, as usual. My father is not around, as usual. My mother just left. I don't know, she should be on her way now, though. Oh, yeah. Let me go get my handbag, all right? I'll join you soon.
Are you going out?
Yes, I have to be in the salon. I have an appointment to make my nails. You're going to accompany me, right?
Actually, I'm supposed to drop by at Kate's place. Just to give her a message.
Must you do that?
Okay, we'll go together. Then I stop by her house, give her the message. Then we can go to the salon together.
Oh, God. That girl, I don't know why you hang around with that kind of girl. That girl is too cheap. You know?
Yeah, see?
Hi,
All right.
I'm ready.
Let's go.
Okay. I hope you have money for fuel because you're going to fuel my car.
Wait till that's
cheap. Let's go.
Look at you. It will be capital intensive.
Yeah, but I will do it for 2 years. Then the amount I use for 2 years, let me go and complete that one.
Well, it's okay. Yeah.
Thank you.
Mama. Mama, where have you been?
I'm in the guest room talking with James.
James, what are you troubling Mama with this time?
Is it me troubling her or she troubling me with issues on how the whole world has got to marry except me?
Yeah, man. Oh, it's not the matter. Why are you people laughing?
His father married me when he was just 22 years old.
Mama Jane, 100,000 can buy 7 plots of land. But today, 1 million naira is just house rent for a flat.
Oh.
Anyway, all I'm saying is that before he starts this new business you are going to link him up with, he must first of all get married.
It's okay, Mama, it's okay. Marriage is first a thing of the mind, yes. Then of the pocket. I know James has his plans.
Okay. I have my plans.
Mm. Yes. You're talking of plans. Anyway, I must not fail to thank you for the way you have helped me organize my family. They say, Uncle Puccioni.
It's the will of God, Mama, not mine. The will of God.
I never even knew my daughter would finish secondary education because of the way things were with us. But he just came, fiam, took her home, trained her up to university level. Today she's a graduate.
An accountant.
This one. You even helped link him up with a business in Port Harcourt. What more should I say? But that no gobble onye.
Mama, all glory be to God. The little world I have is not mine, but God's. And he directs me on how to use it to do his good will.
That is true. Thank you very much.
Mama, look at the time. I want to go to the market. It's getting late.
It's true.
Mama, go. I'm hungry.
Leave him alone. I'll get married when the time comes.
When the right time comes.
He's your elder brother. Huh? You won't tell him not to go and get married.
Alright.
And it's my honest one. Okay. Sit down here and be laughing. Right time.
It is his
right time to come and marry. Right time to get his own.
Alright, okay.
Thank you. Hello, Victoria. Hi, Dawn. I'm coming for your place. The gate man told me you came to the salon, and I know this is your favorite spot. Come on, how about your parents? Are they back from the trip?
Since you are well informed about their trip, you should also know when they should be back.
Come on, I'm a magician, man. I just came around because I felt you might be through by now. But I don't know how much time you still have. All the same, I'm willing to wait.
Please, I still have a few hours to make my nails, and I want to be comfortable with it.
No problem. Since I want to speak with you, I want to talk to you, I'm willing to wait. Can I get you something from the snacks bar over there?
No, thanks.
Problem then. I'll be waiting outside.
Victoria, who is that guy? I mean, seem quite rather nice.
Helen, I barely know him.
If he was coming from your place and knows your parents, girl, that is knowing if you ask me.
Everybody in this town know my parents. They're bankers, remember?
Mm-hmm. So, are you going out with him?
Helen! Oh, please, spare me that. God. And what makes you think that every man that talks to me, that I must date the person? Please say another thing.
I'm backing off.
Intend to talk to you because I have other engagements which I wouldn't want you to disturb.
See, it's not really going to be a disturbance. Just a few words, that's all.
Really? Okay. Then say it. Let's make the rest of the day useful. I'm choked for time.
You see, Victoria, I've been making efforts to see you and have your attention just for a while. Well, it's just that you always appear disgusted each time you come around.
So, this is what you tracked me down here for?
Now, tell me, what it is that I've done wrong? Just tell me, I apologize. You don't seem to understand how much it hurts to be turned down by an angel like you. You have to give me attention.
Okay, let me break it down for you. Hmm? Michael, I don't know who you are, and I don't intend to know you. You and I have nothing to talk about. So please, let's just keep it a high hello thing, okay?
But you see, I just like saying.
Hello. Please, let's go. Michael, thanks for coming around to see me. Yeah?
Thank you.
Look, seriously, who is that guy?
Just one guy that thinks if he says hi to Victoria, then she will fall like a pack of cats.
What are you talking about?
Just because he got a job in one insurance company, that gave him the guts to walk up to me and my parents to talk about marriage.
Really?
Yeah.
He must have plans.
Whatever plans he has, I am not interested. He's not just my type and class.
So what you're saying is no money, no marriage.
Helen, let me ask you one question. Do you have anything against being rich?
No, but not at the expense of my happiness.
And what happiness do you intend to have in a marriage with the means to foot the bills?
Girl, you just said he works, so he has a job and a mind to settle down.
Even wheelbarrow pushers have jobs and minds to settle down. Just step up a little bit, okay?
What are you doing?
I am wearing my husband's jacket. If you're jealous, go and wear your
own. No, actually, it looks very good on your game.
Thank you, Dad.
So, you're ready for the market with your mother?
Yes, I am. So, how do I look? I hope I'm okay.
I don't know. Well, it all depends on how many men want to charm at the market.
No, I still need you to tell me how I look.
Girl, you're looking sweet. Why do you think I married you?
Thank you, darling. Thank you, darling.
Here is 150,000
naira. 150,000
naira
for what?
Darling, you're going to the market with your mother. Go into a boutique, buy anything you want to buy. Shop around a little more, so that when she goes back to the village, they will know that she has a solid son-in-law.
Sister, don't you think 150,000 naira is just too much?
Okay, maybe I should take that and give you 150 naira.
Mommy!
Message you sent to me, did you send it when you were sleeping?
Which message is that, Mama?
You gave Clara 150,000 naira just for shopping. Come on, how much do they sell one plot of land? I gave it back to her to give you. It's too much. You have to cut it down.
Mama, no, please don't. Mama, I want you to look good, okay? Really good. Your daughter will be with me here, radiating beauty and charm, while you will be in the village complimenting that beauty and charm. Don't worry, Mama, this is just the beginning. Calm down, enjoy yourself.
Chineke me. Oh, thank you very much.
Thank you too, Mama.
Wherever this one came from, the sea will never dry.
Amen, amen.
Look at me. You have carried all my burden. A poor widow like me,
because of you. People now call me Tiki Madam all over the place. Thank you very much. God will bless you, Owam.
Amen. Mama, I've got to run, okay? Have a wonderful day shopping.
Okay, my son. Have a nice day at work.
Eh? I will, Mama.
Thank you again. Oh, God bless you for me. Eh?
Amen, Mama. Amen.
Hey. 150,000 naira just for shopping. This is my in-law. Okay. Thank God. Hey, Clara! Let me go and make my basket so we can go to the market now.
This is a good result.
Thank you.
Nice creation.
Thank you.
But I'm sorry.
Mr. Odoma, please. I really appreciate all the help you can offer me towards helping my wife secure a job in your office, please.
Well, I wish there is something here for your wife. She has a good result. We are currently overstaffed. And the only vacancy available is for an engineer.
Mr. Odoma, is there no place where you can attach my wife, even if it's temporary, pending when there is an opening for her?
If there is, I will not hesitate to tell you. Why don't you try Petromec?
Petromec? Petromec is an all-servicing company. My wife read accountancy.
Who knows? They may need someone with her qualification. You can find their address at this place. You can have it.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Why didn't you hold on to my wife's CV, Mr. Mudoma? Who knows? Something might come up.
No problem.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Sorry.
The human resources manager, Mr. Yemi Badi, says to give you this.
Thank you.
Is it possible to get a date to check back or a number to call?
No, that won't be necessary. All shortlisted candidates will be contacted in due course.
So, do you have any idea when that might be?
No, but since your CV is here, I'll contact you when needed.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Have a nice day.
That is what marriage does to people like us.
You can say that again.
Where are you going to? I want to drop the gown I used for the wedding somewhere behind the street.
Really?
So I just said, let me come and greet my girl.
Yeah.
Anyway, why didn't you come for my wedding?
Oh my God, girl, I am so, so sorry. Please forgive me. You know, actually, I wasn't in town, you know. I traveled out. Didn't tell you? I told her to tell you. I'm so sorry. I had an urgent message to deliver for my father, so I had to do it. I'm so sorry, okay? Don't worry, I'm going to make it up to you.
Anyway, I am still waiting on my wedding gift, and I hope I won't wait for too long.
Why would you wait? Don't worry.
Anyway, my dears, duty calls. I have to make something for my husband.
Rub it in.
Okay. Status has changed. Yes, I have my time to spend on more important things than to press buttons.
Don't worry. I'll try and see you this weekend.
Okay,
bye-bye.
Yes. No,
bye-bye then.
You traveled.
Oh, God.
Girl, what is funny?
Girl, no. I had to cook up one story now. Hey, God, this girl will not kill me, God. Can you imagine? She actually hired her wedding gown. Hi. God forbid. Helen, you know me now. Mm. Eh? My own wedding gown is going to be straight from Italy. Everything they will put on that day. From my flower girls, the bridesmaid, everybody is going to look tushed. Trust me. Can you imagine? She didn't even go for any honeymoon. She's just here in Nigeria, perambulating from one office to another.
She's job hunting.
What a pathetic story. Girl, I will not suffer like that in this country. The kind of husband I am going to get married to, society men, people that matters in Nigeria, people that talks, money talks and bullshit works. That is the kind of husband I am going to marry. Trust me.
Find a man first.
Of course I will. You know me now, Victoria. You know me. Rich men, those are the men that I like. Money, personalities. I'm so sorry for that girl. So sorry.
You get married to someone and you put the person in your house and he's just suffering. You know that I'm not even game for all that.
Are you serious?
I'm telling you.
I mean, you've been to several establishments just to submit my CV.
And I still have more to go to. But the problem is, everybody everywhere claims there is no job. I know there is. And even if it takes me to the end of the earth, I will get you one. I promise.
Are you sure you're not stressing yourself?
Hey.
I mean, no, don't get me wrong, girl. I really appreciate all your efforts, but you need to rest. Take a rest. Then face your own job, at least for a while.
My wife is my first business. Your affairs are part of my business. And like I did promise you, there is nothing I will not provide for you. Not only because you're my wife, but because I love you very much.
I love you too, though.
I know.
But I still think you should rest.
Okay. Let me do my own thing, okay? Let me get to the job first, then I will rest, okay? You want a career, don't you?
Well,
yes.
Oh, God.
That's all that. Let me make this call.
Issued a check for 60 million naira to Panam Trade Organization.
Yes. And please, I would also like to get my account balance.
Okay.
Other account.
Okay. You have to write the name of the person you issued a check to and the mode of identification, please. Okay, thank you.
I have with me three checks for 4 million each.
Okay.
Can you pay them in for me?
Of course.
But you have to take those to the banking hall. And I assure you that the person you issued the check for 60 million naira will have no problem clearing it here. Here's your account balance. Here. Have a nice day.
Thank you very much.
Oh, thank you very, very much. I appreciate it.
You're very welcome.
Thank you. Helen, do you know this guy that just left this office right now? Is really, really needy. He has close to 500 million naira in his account.
So, what is special about that?
Such men do not come for my hand in marriage. All that I attract are all those 100,000 naira per salary office boys.
All fingers are not equal, Vicky.
And mine will not be short in the name of Jesus. Amen. Helen, do you know the other guy that came here this morning? The one that came here this morning now? Have you forgotten? That one is a director in a chemical company. As young as he is, he controls not less than 300 million naira in his account.
Victoria, we are bankers. We count other people's money. That's what we do. Men that walk in and out of here are... Well, most of them are people with millions in their accounts. So don't, because of that, insist that you must marry one of them.
And what was that supposed to mean? The women they got married to, what is so special about them? Do they have two heads?
It is their destiny.
Oh, really? And my own destiny, as you presume, is to accept the chicken change earner as a husband.
This one, I wonder who you'll get married to.
You,
Helen. Yeah. Helen. Vicky, I thought you were going out.
I was, but I ran into this guy downstairs. Please, can you help me check this account name for me in the computer?
Why? Who is he?
Just check it for me. Mr. Austin again.
Let's see. Your account is not that strong. He's on loan. 3 million naira loan from the bank.
What? Rubbish.
What is the problem, Vicky?
Can you imagine? The idiot saw me downstairs and gave me his bloody card.
So?
He wants to go out with me. He wants a relationship with me. Tomorrow, if he defaults from the loan he took from the bank, then I will be dragged into it. I'm not interested.
You met a guy. And your criteria for going out, for deciding whether to go out with him is the balance of his bank account?
You don't get it, do you? I am not his type. Simple. See you later, girl.
Upstairs.
In her room?
Yes, in her room.
Mom, have you been able to speak with her of late?
Concerning what?
Marriage, mom. Mom, 7 suitors have been here. All she does to turn them down. It's not fair.
Maybe she's taking her time.
Oh, Mom, there you go again, taking her time. What time? Mom, she must have taken all her time while in school. All through the period she started working. Mom, there is time for everything. What time does she want?
Are you now suggesting that she jumps into the hands of any man that comes knocking on her door because she is running out of time?
Not so, Mom. Not so, Mom, but you believe me that Daddy is not happy about this. He's not. And Mom, perhaps you've been giving her wrong impression about marriage.
My dear, not that I've been giving her wrong impression. She will get her right man when the right one comes.
Mom, she can never choose the right one until you show her the right path.
Kenneth.
Mom.
My daughter will not go out looking for men. They will come here looking for her.
Exactly what I'm saying, Mom. 7 suitors. 7 suitors have been here. What does she do? Turn them down. Why?
Kenneth.
Mom.
My daughter Victoria is beautiful.
I know.
She's educated.
Of course.
And she is matured.
Mom, not in this contest. Not in this contest at all. Mom, please talk to her. Please.
Kenneth.
Mommy.
You are too small for this topic you're raising now. Did you hear me? Go to the kitchen and carry your food.
Mom?
I said, go and carry your food in the kitchen. Children. You did not come to the dining to eat with me. Is it because your father is not around?
Mommy. How can you say that? Haven't I been eating with you before? It's just that I'm not hungry. Don't worry, I'll eat later.
Victoria, I keep imagining the day I'll visit your own house to see you managing your husband's account so well.
Mom, I know where you're going with that.
Several men have been here. Your brother just talked sense into me. I mean, I cannot stand the suspense any longer. Talk to me, Victoria.
But Mom, do you call those boys men? I've reviewed all of them one after the other. None of them have what I want in a marriage.
But your father believes that...
My father believes that he is the right person to choose for me. But Mom, I don't think so.
My daughter, sometimes what you search for in a man could not be seen from the view of a small child.
Mom, I am an adult. I know the right man for me when I see him. For now, I don't think I've seen the right person I want to settle down with.
Perhaps the stake you raised was so high?
Mom, the stake is very, very low. But they're overlooking it simply because they are not the right people for me.
They're not the right people.
Mom, please, when the right time comes, I'll get married. That's when I see the right person for me. Mom, please. Mom, enjoy the music.
Enjoy what?
It's an oil deal that's worth $500 million for a period of 3 years. I want to make sure that all the necessary legal clauses are attended to.
Would I be providing technical assistance and also cater for the expatriates that will be coming?
Yes, yes, of course. But the problem is that it wasn't specified here.
It has to be, so that we should know the party that is responsible for the financial aspect of the thing.
Yes.
Anyway, you come to my office tomorrow, we'll talk about this.
Fine with me. You're the lawyer.
Hello.
Ah, Victoria, you are here as planned, eh?
Yes.
That is everything.
Everything is
cool. Jide? Yes. Meet Victoria. She's my account officer. She works with Metro Bank.
Really?
Yeah. Victoria, this is Jide Oshoba. He's an industrialist and an oil merchant.
It's my pleasure meeting you. But your name sounds familiar.
Well, that my surname, that is. That's if you're familiar with the former governor.
Your father was a one-time governor?
Yes, but I don't like attaching myself to his apron string. You see, I'm my own man.
Really? It's an honor meeting you.
Well, smack out of it. The pleasure is mine. You see, pretty things like you hardly come my way in a day's work. I'd like to meet you again sometime.
Okay. Here is my card.
Okay.
Can I have yours?
Oh, definitely. Definitely, of course. You reach me with this.
Surely get to me through that line.
Just. All right,
so,
we'll see
in your office tomorrow.
All right.
So, see you soon.
Such a gentleman. Is he married?
No, but he's doing very fine. He is about to sign a $500 million worth of contract with a foreign oil firm.
Wow, that's a lot of money. I would like to handle his accounts.
Well, you have his phone number.
Oh, yeah.
Well, come to my office tomorrow. We'll talk about that.
Thank you. So, back to business. I couldn't lay my hand on your account statement. It's not ready yet. But I can assure you that it will be ready by tomorrow. So maybe I'll bring it while coming to your office.
So what can I offer you?
Victoria.
Oh, hello, Vicky, how are you?
I'm fine. Well, I just wanted to know how you're doing.
I'm fine, I'm fine. And you?
I'm good. You sound as if you're far away. As if you're not in town or something.
No, no, I'm at home, at home. Listen, Vicky, I don't know. What's your tomorrow like? I mean, you got anything doing tomorrow?
Well, it depends on what you have in mind. Do you want to spice it up a little bit for me?
That's my girl. Now listen, what's my name? Now, that's something I really want to do, and I know how to do it very well. Perhaps a dinner in the evening. Is that okay with you?
Yeah, it's okay by me. It will give me an opportunity to see you again. So how is your father?
It's fine, it's fine. He's in London. He's chilling.
Mm.
I'll pick you up tomorrow then.
Alright then. See you later.
Right, bye.
Bye. Night-night. Ooh. Let me call Helen. Hey girl, what's up? Don't tell me you're sleeping by this time. What's going on now? My dear, I have a date with GD tomorrow.
So, tell me about yourself.
Well, there's nothing special about me. Open-minded.
Mm-hmm.
Sentimental.
Mm-hmm.
Tolerant. And I believe in the good things of life through hard work.
My pastor says the same.
The pastor?
Now tell me. How's a romantic life?
Well,
Now. Who's the boyfriend that allowed you out of the cage? Because I know there are a whole lot of them.
Really? You really want to know?
Yeah.
Now, you tell me. Who is the girl that allowed you, or should I say, who is the girl that allowed you out this evening?
Well, I know a lot of girls, as friends, as colleagues, some as business associates, but that doesn't mean I sleep with a whole lot of them.
Good to hear. My pastor said the same thing.
My lawyer says you are the head of financial operations, retail banking, in your place of work. So what have you got to say for yourself?
Well, responsibilities one has to place as a career.
I see. So, how did a girl like you come to such a position?
Does that bother you?
No, of course not. I'm impressed. It's an achievement. Just that I've met quite a number of girls your age and all they do is jump from one hotel to the other.
Different strokes for different folks. Now tell me, Jide.
Yes.
Tell me more about yourself. Barrister Justice says that you are in the oil business. And he has said a whole lot about you. But I really want to hear from the horse's mouth.
And the horse's mouth you hear from?
I'm waiting.
Now where do I start? Well, I'm just like every other hardworking man.
Mm.
I'm into oil exploration. And equipment leasing. At four times, I've dabbled into communications and marketing.
Ooh.
And that's that.
Impression that you are a workaholic.
Thank you.
Hey, was that a kiss? I just saw.
You were peeping at us.
Hell. Come to think of it, I haven't seen you like this for a very long time. I mean, this you. But you're floating. Out with it. What is going on?
Girl, nothing is going on. Love is in the air.
Oh, God. You're in love with him already?
Of course I am.
So soon?
Oh, please. Oh, God. This guy. God, Helen. He possesses all the qualities I want in a man. What else am I waiting for? Huh?
Are you sure about this?
Girl, I am dead. Serious?
I mean, you just met the guy barely a week ago.
Yeah? Girl, you need to see this guy. This guy is gorgeous. This guy is so handsome. This guy is something else. I can go on and on. This guy has got lots of cash. He is loaded. And he's from a known family. You need to see the places he took me to. Girl, I have never been to such places all my life. And this guy is well-traveled. This guy is something else. Oh, my God.
Any man that is opportune will be all that and achieve all he has achieved. So let's bring it down to the simple things, you know? Like his character. Are you compatible with him? Does he treat you nice? Does he value you?
Really, Helen, values? Just like you said, any man that is opportuned, very few of them are opportuned. Girl, trust me, this guy is... And I am keeping this one. Yeah.
You are serious?
Yeah. Girl, just believe me, okay?
I want to believe you. So, do I hear wedding bells?
Not yet, girl. He hasn't proposed, but I am so sure that he will do that very soon. This guy is in love with me. I have finally found my man, girl.
This is what's celebrated.
Of course it is.
Let me use it as a point of contact.
Oh, point of contact to what?
Hello. Oh, you want married?
Oh, you want to get married? Oh, really? God, I am celebrating this one. I hope you have champagne in your room. Because I'm going right there to blow it open.
What have you been doing all day with you?
What?
I didn't say I want to finish everything.
Who be that?
Come here, sir. Good day, please.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon.
Please, is this Mrs. Clara Festus' residence?
Yes, sir.
You share home? I have a mail for her.
Okay, wait, sir. She does.
Please, are you Mrs. Clara Festus?
Yes.
I have a mail for you, please. But you have to sign for collection for me. You write your name, the address.
Okay.
Here. Yeah, you sign there. Then, yeah, sign it. Yeah, you write the date.
John, open the gate for him.
Thank you very much.
Okay, sir.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus. Hello? Mommy, mom.
Hello?
It is Clara, mommy.
Clara? Good afternoon, my daughter. How are you? What is it?
Yes, I have finally gotten the job, mommy.
Really?
I'm very sure from the oil company. I have the letter here.
Hey! 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 God, I thank you. Hey! Oil company. What is it now, Diego? Hey! Jesus, I thank you. Jehovah, thanks. Chere, you got it. Have you told your husband yet?
No. He's not yet home, but he will soon be home. Hey, thank God, mommy. Mommy, I will call you back. I just called you to tell you. I will call you back later.
Bye-bye, Oma. Bye-bye, yo.
I'll call you back.
Hey, Jesus. Hey. Are you company? What is it now, Diego? Jesus, thanks, sir. Jehovah, thanks, sir. Are you company? What is it now, Diego?
This isn't fair, sir. This isn't fair. At the moment, why doesn't he allow me to make my one phone call? No, I need to talk to my lawyer.
Don't worry, let's get to the reception first.
But this isn't fair, you know it.
Mr. Festus, you're a businessman that imports printing papers and stationeries from Asia.
Yes, and I've been in the business now for 11 years.
What are the contents of the 11 containers you brought into this country?
Printing papers and stationery, of course.
Well, I'm afraid not, Mr. Festus.
What are you talking about, officer? I imported printing papers and stationery.
Your clearing agents were all around. When all your containers were opened, they were filled up with used tires and all were contraband.
What I imported are printing papers and stationery. That's all.
Well, we have to proceed. The investigation has to take your statements. The Customs Task Force brought the information to us. And I'm assuring you that you must be detained pending when we are through with the investigation.
Officer, look, I don't understand this. Believe me, I don't. I swear it to you. What I ordered from China are printing papers and stationery. Officer, let us look into this. I know nothing about used tires. I don't import used tires. I know nothing about them. There should be a mistake somewhere. Officer, believe me, please. Believe me.
Well, Mr. Festus, I'm through with you.
Forrester, where is my husband? What is he doing at the station?
My dear, calm down. It is nothing. Your husband will be alright.
How can you say it is nothing when he's there? Okay, were you able to reach him?
Yes. The Chinese your husband imports goods from loaded fairly used tires for him instead of the printing materials he ordered for.
Why are they detaining him now? It is not his fault. Why are they detaining him?
Like I said before, everything will be alright. He has made a statement. The customs officer has insisted on burning the goods. Don't worry, he will soon be out there, okay?
When? How will he be released? When?
I've petitioned the Chinese Trade Commission here and also faxed a letter to the company that shipped the goods. Don't worry, your husband will soon be out of there.
Jesus. What kind of headache is this one now? Eh? What kind of headache is this?
Calm down. Your husband is not a criminal. He will soon come out.
Okay. Okay. What do I offer you?
My dear, don't worry. I don't need anything now. I just come to see how you're doing. I think I should be on my way now.
Okay, let me see you.
Thank you very much.